I'm in an awkward position here. First of all, I don't condone that behavior. I want to make that absolutely clear. And I'm not advocating beating up on young people.
But
that said, I've had occasion to interact and work with some young people as of late. And I can certainly see sometimes how people get to that point where they want to do something like that. And again, that's not excusing it. I'm saying push to the line where they want to. And this is the point, that I suspect that this young 16-year-old is not an angel. We live in a climate now, cultural climate, where a lot of young people are not disciplined by the schools so that they are not threatened. They talk back.
That is
not
the job of the officer. That is not the job of the officer.
I'm agreeing with you. I'm agreeing with you. All I'm trying to do is add a little bit of context.
I am confused is the kindest word I can say about these kinds of behaviors. We covered a story a while ago about a teen who stole a wallet from a stranger in the park. And my panel, I think we had an audience here then too, was defending this stranger who did a similar kind of punishment to the kid that stole a wallet because he wouldn't go home and wouldn't let this guy take the kid home to his mom. So this guy took the law into his own hands. But my question is, why is this what you're about to see any different than what the law enforcement did, other than the fact that these guys are officers and we expect more from them? Take a look.
Some people gonna think I'm wrong for this, but he's 14 years old, and this is why kids do this. You feel me? I don't even want to do this, bro. Dog.
Your ass. Not good.
Dude, why are you stealing from people?
Bad.
I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. I'm so
tell him you're sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
It's sort of this.
Some people don't think I'm wrong for this, but
Joseph, it's sort of the same thing. It's a stranger who grabs a young kid of sort of junior high school age, and starts beating on him. It's not different.
I'm a little lost for words. The difference, of course, is that we do expect more from our law enforcement officers.
Yeah.
But again, I just want to emphasize this point, that in our school systems now, we have unleashed the beast, and we have young people who are not afraid, who are not respectful. They are rude. They talk back. And I've been in schools where students have actually drawn up on teachers.
Yeah, but Joseph, well, I would argue the reason is because they're probably getting whipped like that at home.
That's how they learn how to be violent and aggressive. Over and over again, physical, corporal punishment does not teach them to be peaceful. It teaches them just the opposite.
And I don't advocate corporal punishment.
Police officers do not belong in schools unless you have the proper training to deal with students.
They're school police officers.
Exactly. Policing in a school environment is much different than policing out in the streets.
Spirit, I hear you trying to come in. Come on.
Yeah, you know, it's just frustrating because I hear Joseph's point and I empathize with that, working in the schools and all of that myself. But there is nothing that contextualizes this that makes this situation okay. And what you're saying is almost like, well, in certain situations, there have been instances where a certain group of people have done this. So that somehow makes this okay. We don't know any backstory on this young man. We don't know anything that would even remotely tie him to what you're contextualizing on the other side. And at the end of the day, these officers took an oath to protect and serve. And they did neither of that with this young man on that day.
And that is the bottom line. Can I just clarify? Because, Spirit, I want you to understand that I agree with you and that I'm not attempting to excuse the behavior. The point I'm trying to make is that that something that we are doing also in the school systems, whereby not holding kids accountable for their behavior creates this climate. But that is not to say that I'm advocating cops beating.
You're linking two things together that aren't necessarily connected, though, Joseph.
And let me
the climate, I think, is there.
Let me unfairly throw up some gunpowder on this. What if the officer had been white? Would we be having an entirely different conversation about this?
Probably.
No, my comments would have still been the same.
But I'm also saying that at one point, I was, on social media, and I was rah-rah, just 100% exactly what everyone else is saying. And then I got some experience under my belt, and now I say, you know what? I still am not advocating it, but I understand the pressure. I understand what goes on, and I understand how people get to this point, and we don't always see that part of the story.
I mean, that's why we have school police on campus now, which we didn't have years ago. But that doesn't mean you use physical punishment. You have other ways to be able to deal with
Spirit,
these situations.
I hear the frustration in your voice. Go ahead, finish this out.
Because you know why, Dr. Drew? You know what I see when I look at this video? I don't see just an officer. What I see in this video is sublimation. I see a man who is out of control.
Who's losing it,
And so I look at this and go, if he beat this stranger, this young boy this way, who else has he harmed like this in his life? We've
heard that
there's some domestic violence allegedly between him and his partner. I'm sure that we would see that with his children. This is a man who takes and abuses power. And if he did it here, this is just one example. We will hear as the time goes on. Mark my words, we will be back having this conversation. The stories will come out where he's done this in many other places and spaces.
You're right. We've heard some things like this. And as I've learned repeatedly from Sergeant Cheryl, who we have on the show, retired LAPD police sergeant, that, listen, we want to support the police, but there are guys out there that lose it in certain situations, and this is a misconduct. This is an abuse of power, and they need to be properly, if not schooled, then they need to be properly handled by the law.